What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Scott, and we're here to talk about season 46 of Survivor. Crazy to think it's already here and we're on season 46, but this is kind of just the pre-show cast analysis of some of the cast members, a few predictions, but Survivor season 46 does kick off tomorrow night at 8 p.m., 2-hour premiere again on CBS, but we're just going to go over a couple players to watch. Who I believe has what it takes to go the distance this season. I believe we have about 5 names on this list that we're going to talk about. So, obviously, all of this is just judging a book by its cover because we do only have the few pre-show interviews that these cast members have done and their bios online. So, obviously, not a whole lot to go off of, but we're just going to jump to conclusions and, you know, kind of predict with what we have right now on who we think can go the distance here in season 46 of Survivor. So let's just jump right in. First off, I have Banu Gopal, a 41-year-old IT quality analyst, originally from India, now living in Massachusetts. He is described as an adaptable and dependable person, which is huge in this game, and describes himself as someone who is good at making first impressions. He wants to play the game like Cochran. Given his energy and passion towards the game that was transpired in his pre-show interviews, I can see him getting into the right alliance and going far in this game. Next up, we have Kenzie Petty, a 29-year-old salon owner, currently living in Charlotte, North Carolina, but did grow up about an hour from where I did here in Michigan. She's resilient, resourceful, and self-driven are some of the words that her friends use to describe her. She's willing to take risks like opening her own salon with no business degree or plan. Taking that risk is an asset if used correctly in this game. Lastly, she wants to play like Marianne, a former winner, obviously just a couple seasons ago, a new school winner as well. We've seen it in a lot of the new era. If you have good energy, you're able to connect with people, which it seems like she has and she might be able to, then you can go far in this game. Next up, Charlie Davis, a 26-year-old law student from Boston. Now, the weird thing is, this kind of just a side personal note, weird thing is I'm someone who usually hates, who cannot stand Boston as a whole, mainly because of sports, but often times I end up liking people from Boston on Survivor, you know, Boston Rob, one of my 2 favorite players of all time, Jake from last season, from season 45 of Survivor. Just thought that was an interesting analysis, you know, how this game can, you know, really, no matter where you're from, you know, people can connect with you. Now, enough about me, back to Charlie here. Not much analysis here, but lawyers, if they don't get too arrogant or too ahead of themselves, full of themselves, should you say, usually go pretty far in this game. He describes himself as loyal, but can he mix that loyalty with strategy and scheming that ideally you'd think someone who is in law school would have? Then if he can do that and blend those together, get in the right alliance, he has what it takes with those, you know, qualities to win this game and, you know, make it far. Wants to play like Spencer Bledsoe and Christian Hubicki. If he can get with the right alliance and successfully pull the strings behind the scenes to get to the final 3, I think, you know, obviously him having that experience in law school, he'll be able to tell a compelling story about his game and explain why he deserves to win and be able to convince the jury why. I mean, that is what he's going into to do for a living. So if he can do those things, I think he's got a shot. Next up, Q Burdett, a 29-year-old real estate agent from Memphis, Tennessee. One of the 3 adjectives he used to describe himself was polite. Now, if he can mix politeness in the game of Survivor and using his skills as a real estate agent, that could be a lethal combo. Getting on people's good side, you know, being friends kind of with everyone, but having, you know, an alliance and, you know, people you can trust, then that could be a lethal combo that could help propel him in this game. Now, another player who is willing to take risks. He quit his job to pursue a career in real estate and becoming one of the top real estate agents in the country. We saw from one of his intro package interviews. If he can get in a good alliance and keep his threat level down, he could go a long way. Now, second to last player to watch out for this season, in my opinion, is Liz Wilcox, a 35-year-old marketing strategist from Orlando, Florida. She's also originally from Michigan, about 3 hours away from where I grew up here. She seems like a fun player who is going to be authentically herself out on the island, and I think she will be able to make connections with a lot of people where she will have solid alliances throughout the game. She's someone who believes in herself and is a public speaker who overcame being mute until she was 7 and had a nervous tic hyperventilating from nerves. So I believe she can use that to her advantage in this game, having overcome adversity like that in her life already, transpiring that into the game. Wants to kind of an interesting combo who she wants to play with. Wants to play like Russell and Sandra, kind of two similar players, but who play the game completely differently. If she can be that fun-loving player who connects with everyone, like the energy that she gave off in her intro video, while also playing like those two in Russell and Sandra, under the surface, she could go pretty far. And now, to who I believe will win Survivor Season 46, drumroll please, Venus Vaifa, a 24-year-old data analyst from Toronto, Ontario. Now, yes, I had to throw a Canadian in the mix here because they have dominated the show and been really successful since Canadians were allowed to come on the show back in 2019, season 39. We've seen two winners, Erica Casupani, Survivor 41. I'm sorry, Erica, if I mispronounced your last name. I know I did. And Marianne Oktech, winner of Survivor 42. I'm sorry, again, Marianne, probably mispronounced your last name. But along with many other Canadians who have gone far in the game and been really successful in the 5 years since Canadians have been allowed to come on Survivor. But that's not the only reason I have this pick. She's a data analyst, so obviously she's good at numbers and strategizing in certain situations, but also has a hobby of playing poker, which Survivor is basically a big game of poker. We've seen former players playing in poker tournaments, call back to the Poker Alliance of Season 40 of Boston Rob, Parvati, and Tyson. Self-described as someone who is very observant, which is key in this game, and becoming fast friends with people who can earn her high threshold of trust and become thick as thieves. And if you have someone who you're thick as thieves with and you can actually trust, usually if you can keep that kind of low-key, you can go pretty far in this game. We've seen it season after season for 20-plus years, 40-plus seasons of the show. If you can successfully do that and keep it kind of, close-knit and not have people to be too suspecting of that, you can make it pretty far in this show. Wants to play like Parvati and Suri, great mix of two of the best players to ever play this game. If she can keep her self-described sassiness from rubbing people the wrong way, because, obviously being on the island, high-stress situations, sometimes some of that, comes out. If she can keep that under control and doesn't rub people the wrong way, with that, as we said, self-described sassiness that she talked about in her bio in the pre-show, then I think she will be able to find roads into alliances and can control the game if she can play the way that she wants to, talking about coming into this season. So there you have it, just a little preview and prediction of Survivor Season 46. Looking forward to diving in to this season tomorrow night, and we'll be back Thursday morning following the episode for a recap of the 2-hour premiere of Survivor 46. Talk to y'all later. Peace out.